we know that the most important part of our organization is people. I was talking about our pillars, and one of them is thoughtful data. And we use that data so we can know specifically what does child A need in this classroom at this point in time to make sure that they are prepared to go to the next step. We use that same level of thinking with individual adults and how we can help you grow to be able to continue to further your impact.
Democracy Prep offers individualized supports within a strong framework because we've really developed a lot of ways to codify our systems over time. Every single person that joins our organization, we want to know their story, we want to know their strengths, we want to know what their key growth areas are, because we also want them to be able to bring their creativity and their source of brilliance to the table. And so they're able to problem solve and think about new ways to do things within the strong framework that we have.
The support comes through your colleagues, your teachers, through your school leaders, through your coaches, again, all of them whom have been through, you know, this kind of path and this walk before. I meet with my supervisor to talk through the initiatives that I have planned for the arts.
DP offered individualized support. It started actually with my mentor teacher last year, Joseph Robinson. He was my mentor, but he was also like a big brother to me. I would also say, especially this year, my coach, Lucy Schultz, has provided that individualized support for me. She keeps me within this strong framework of being the best teacher that I can possibly be, especially during my second year of teaching.
Being a teacher and being a principal, honestly, were two of the best jobs in the world. But I think the reason that I was excited to be CEO is just to extend my reach. I think I've really benefited at Democracy Prep from people trusting me and allowing me to assume leadership in my own authentic voice. And so that's something I really want to bring to the CEO role and make sure that even though I have these incredibly high expectations on behalf of kids, that I'm also remembering that people want to feel valued and that they're able to be creative and autonomous too.
The network will establish very clear lines for success and things that we know are best practices, but at the same time, they give school leaders the autonomy to apply those principles in their own schools, because we know that every school has its own context. And even, you know, in the arts, I can do that as well. So I can, you know, take things that I've learned over the years from great teaching, about great leadership, things that I've been learning the last couple years, and now apply that to arts education.
I think some of the best support that I've been given to this point has been my opportunity to go and visit some of our other great schools. The way school happens in San Antonio versus Baton Rouge versus Camden, we have similar problems. We have children from a similar demographic. We can take some of these great ideas and then make sure that we combine them with the things that we're already doing well.
I think being a CEO, especially one that has grown up in the organization and sort of occupied a bunch of different seats, it gives me that proximity to schools where I remember what it's like to be a teacher and I remember what it's like to be a principal. But I also now have all of this context of working with our senior level team, so I'm able to really bring my experience with just leading and pushing people and really pushing them to be their best.
Every school is slightly different, and yet we're all unified by the values that we hold near and dear and that define us as an organization. So in order for every school to be successful, there has to be knowledge of what's happening on the ground. There has to be knowledge of the specific context in the school. You have to rely on the autonomy for that. They have to bring their own vision to the work, their own vision to the school, for it to be successful, you know, because ultimately that's where the sustainability comes from. People work hard and they commit to a different level when they see themselves in the work.
This is my second year. I realized that during my first year, the why was very apparent, like this is the pivotal years for young adolescents. I'm in a constant loop of like remembering my why.
We foster an environment where we want to make sure that we shout people out, where we talk to one another and let them know the things that they've done well. We spend a lot of time thinking about what is the joy factor we're going to bring to our teachers so people know this isn't a place where you just work hard and you just see the results at the end, but we celebrate you along the way, we have fun along the way, and we want you to be your authentic self.
Being an alum from DP and now being a teacher, I definitely know both sides of the story. It is hard being a student at DP, but I would say it's even harder, but also much more rewarding being a teacher. It's way more than just teaching the students. It's more about knowing who they are, what they need, and how can I, one person, actually help this student get to where they need to be.
There's a lot of people like working really hard, getting really passionate about something that's very important to our our world and to them personally. And so I think that energy is just kind of, it's contagious. I mean, it's just a really supportive environment for excellence, but excellence with this culture of joy.